Zero. Oh, hey.
Hey, we're here. Hello.
We're here.
Good to see you guys.
Thanks
well,
so
kind of.
Awesome.
Awesome. Awesome. Well, we're glad that you could join us on this beautiful day. It's not snowing. If you remember last time we were streaming for a banquet, it was a snowstorm.
We sent Scott Hildebrandt, Elvis, as some of you guys know him. We sent him to go to all the communities to give all the people to donuts to deliver. And I think he barely made it back.
Oh, it was like just in time.
Yeah.
So the snowstorm wasn't quite as bad as he was driving, but it was picking up.
And that snow has just melted now.
And we're in what, April? So
I was out by Dundurn delivering donuts today, and there was definitely still snow in one of the ditches. Like not underneath a tree either, like literally in the ditch. Anyways, enough banter, Doug.
Okay.
Do you want to get this going?
Let's do it.
I think we're
starting. Yep.
So Kahoot.it is a website you want to head to right now. That's KAHOOT.it. It's right there. Oh, wrong way. There. This way. Doug, you went too far over.
Oh, I went too far.
Yeah, go to the website, or if you have the Kahoot app, either way, you put in that code, 855-8410, and enter your name, and you can join our little Kahoot that we have here. What's Kahoot? It's like a game show.
Yeah, I feel like anyone that has grown up in high school or elementary in the last, like, 10 years knows Kahoot.
I guess all of our campers who have been in school all year are probably sick of this. The journalist!
The journalist is first.
Andrew Russell in the house!
Nice. Man, we should have just had him just, you know, wrapping the whole...
Yeah, I guess we could have had him show up, too. All right. Acromion, thanks. That's Glenn.
Nice.
How do I know people's gamer
tag? I was
going to
say, how do you know that one?
Is
that
gamer tag? I am that nerdy. You know, I'm going to move just a little further.
I like it.
Over
I like it. I like
way.
It.
Yeah. Yeah, no, it was really neat delivering donuts today. And I don't know how many of you guys got to enjoy them. Unfortunately, the journalist did not get any because he's way down in Karenport.
Sadly so.
But I know the Chewback family got some, and they. I think they're delicious. When I was outside this morning, Doug, there was a line in front of Nutana Bakery for people to get in and get their orders and make orders. And it was 10 deep. And so our board member, Justin Clausen, was helping me. He and I were standing there bantering. And as we were bantering, the guy looks out and he's like, "Hey, Greg, I got your donuts." Because he knows us from making all these orders now, right? It's a lot of donuts. And we hauled them out. And as there were stacks of donuts coming out of the front door of the donut shop, people were like, "You must be a really good guy to know." You're like, "Yeah, it's a fundraiser for Ranger Lake Bible Camp."
Oh,
so we all
so
had
cool.
a pretty good laugh. One of the guys said to me, he's like, "Yeah, I had these donuts once, and I haven't eaten Tim Hortons donuts since."
It's
so
hard to go back.
It ruins you.
It's hard. Once you know what's out there, it's like, man.
It's hard to go back.
I can't. I really can't. So, thanks for everyone that's joining.
All
right. That is a lot of names.
We should probably get going if we want to make time here, Doug, hey?
Yeah.
So I think that's our limit for the first Kahoot. There's going to be a second one if we have time. So let's go ahead and start Kahoot. Dun, dun, dun.
First question.
Bible facts. How well do you know your Bible? 3, 2, 1, go. How many books are in the Old Testament of the Bible, Doug?
Ooh.
Is it red, 44, blue, 39, orange, 50, or green, 2?
That's a good question.
I don't think it's green.
I don't think so. I will give you that much
there
that green is.
There are two Testaments.
Two Testaments. That's true.
Yep. So I got some final answers coming in here, and let's see.
Hey, good
almost
job.
Oh, one person got tricked.
One person.
There you go. 10 people got it right. Good job. Next one.
Nice.
Ooh, Triggs, my son. Second place. Good job, Triggy. How many books are in the New Testament of the Bible?
Ooh, so we got red, 22, blue, 52, yellow, 27, or green, 4.
It's not 4, Doug.
4?
Why did you put that in there?
I don't know. Because why not, you know?
I take it back. Someone will vote. Give you a sympathy vote for that.
Oh, thank you.
Yes, you got a sympathy vote.
Hey, we did get one.
It's
awesome.
Orange. Yeah, it's 29. So that means, the Peter's party at the
top.
That's one of our camp speakers.
Well done.
Well, the Wilsons are with us. Good to see. How many books are in the are in most Protestant Bibles?
Ooh, so we got red with 66, blue 77, yellow 55, or green 14.
Hopefully you did your math.
Yeah. I actually love this picture of like the periodic table, but it's all books of the Bible.
Oh,
I think it's super nerdy, but
it's
super cool.
Okay. Okay.
Right?
I see what they're doing there. All right, let's see the answer. Dun, dun, dun. 66.
Hey, good job. Good job.
Yep. Oh, the Peters are Catholic, so they got dropped down.
Oh, come on now.
If they're the, I might be wrong. It might be a different Peters family. I don't know. Bible's written over how many years? Was it written over the course of 1,500 years, 10,000 years, 2,000 years, or 10 days?
I mean, 10 days is pretty quick when you think
about it. Speedrunning Bible writing.
It's a lot of writing.
That might be true of the Book of Mormon, actually, but what do I know?
Who knows?
That's not why we're here. I'm going to get fired with all these stupid off. Yes, it's 1,500 years.
Hey,
good job.
Good job.
That one's a lot more difficult, so good for you, for those who got that right. The Y girls up on top. Good job.
Good job.
Next one.
How many authors for the Bible?
Oh, man. I don't even know if I know this.
I know. We got 22 authors in red. We got 60 authors for blue, 12 authors for yellow, and 40 authors for green.
Well, I don't think it's 60. That's way too many.
It's a little high. That's a little high.
It's definitely not 12. I'm going to lock in at 22.
Okay, okay.
What about you? You already know the
answer. I know the answer because I did. It's actually 40.
What?
Around 40 different authors.
And I call myself a camp director.
Yeah.
And not a Bible camp, no less. Oh, Y girls, wow, running away with it. The Dirksen family's up there too.
They just know it.
Ha ha, eagle eye. What gospel is written by the disciple known as the one Jesus loved?
Ooh, we got
it. What gospel? Is it Matthew, Mark, Luke, or John? Or Thomas? Matthew, John, Thomas, or Mark?
Good
question.
Which
one is the one that he loved? Ooh, I think I see a clue there, Doug.
There is a little bit of a clue on this one. I figure if you want to weigh it out, you can. But if you know it, you get more points if you answer quick.
Uh-huh.
So, you know.
Here we go. It looks like it is the Book of John. That's
it
what I
is.
Would say.
I think it is. You
I
got 3 seconds if you haven't locked in yet. So.
Yeah. Hey, good
there
job,
you go.
Everyone.
Good job. Oh.
And that puts Ha-Ha in second place. Good job.
Moving up in the world.
All right. Next up. Quiz.
All right, we've got, in John, how many I am statements does Jesus make?
Mm-hmm.
Ooh, is it 3, 9, 7, or 10?
Okay, I know, I'm almost positive that there's 3 different sections, but he says I am more than once in those sections.
Yes.
So is this counting the number of times he says I am?
It is counting the diversity of the different
ways
he says
so
it.
The total. Okay, I'm going to say 9 then.
Okay, okay.
Let's see if I get it right. What do you think, Austin?
It's actually 7.
Oh, 7?
The number of completion.
Oh, Austin got it right. Good job. Austin's doing the stream for us, so you guys might remember him from past summers at Ranger Lake.
Awesome,
wow,
dude.
Eagle Eye's on fire!
Very nice.
Next question.
True or false? I am the gate is one of the I am statements found in John. Is that true? Is that false? I mean, a gate's kind of a weird statement, but...
I am the gate.
I am the gate.
The gate. Is it a gate? Is it not a gate? We'll find out.
And bonus points if you comment where you find it in John. That would be pretty amazing
John
if that's
10.
True or false.
John 10. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean...
I mean, it's John 10, and it's true, isn't it?
It is true. Yes.
Is it John 10?
It is.
Hey!
Hey, that
I
is
did read
that
it. I did read it today. So.
Wow, that was split. People right down the middle.
Good guessing, everyone. The Wilson family is on the rise. Good job, guys.
Like
Ranger
it.
Paul pulling up the rear. Proud of you, buddy. What is the name of the friend of Jesus who dies and is brought back to life? Noah?
Ooh. Noah, Lazarus, Juan, or Zebedee?
Juan.
I'm personally voting on Juan here.
Juan.
So.
You're the Juan for me. Yeah, Ranger Paul used to be my boss, actually, if it's the same Ranger Paul.
Yeah, that's super cool. Like, how many years ago was that now?
Oh, man. That was 2006 when he moved on. No, oh, no, wow. 2008 when he moved on. So a long, long time ago, 13 years ago.
That is a long
Jeez
time.
Louise. All right. I'm going to say it's Lazarus. Yep.
Hey, and that's actually, you can find it in John chapter, I believe, 11
okay,
or 12.
Right there.
Right at the end. So
Jesus wept, John 11:35.
There
we
go.
Good job, Crow, way out in the lead. Last question. In John 9, Jesus heals a man who had what disability since he was born?
Is it leprosy, unable to walk, too many toes, or blind? Is that a problem, having too many toes?
Can you ever have too many toes?
I don't think you can.
I knew someone with 6 fingers
okay
on one hand.
See, I knew someone that had their big toe removed, and that was weird for them walking, because you would be amazed at how much that changes the dynamic of walking.
For sure. I had a friend at Bible college who lost his thumb, and they took his big toe off and put it on his hand. Weirdest thumb I've ever seen. How did we get here? Okay, what's the answer? Blind. He was blind.
Hey, good job.
You didn't see that one coming, did you?
No.
All right, so third place, the Wilsons.
Hey, good job.
Second place, Crow.
I like
first
that name.
First place. Dun, 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 the Dirksen fam jam.
Wow, you came out of nowhere. Good,
good job, David and family. Proud of you guys. David's one of our camp speakers, often at Dirk Camp. He's from Pleasant Hill Mennonite Church. I'm certain that's their family. If it's not, then it's the Dirksen family from Osler.
Yeah.
And if it's not them, I mean, just... You could throw a stone in any direction, one of those small towns that hit a Dirksen.
We know a lot of Dirksens.
We know a lot of Dirksens.
We do. Yeah. So, no, thank you guys for playing. I think we have time for one more. So
one more?
We will end up playing another one.
Hey, and quit texting me. You turkeys.
Yeah, oh, no, people always do that during streams. They always message us. But we're definitely not looking at our messages till after, just so you
Except
guys
Except for
know.
That one time, because I have a attention of a squirrel. The next one's going to be about Ranger Lake activities. So here's the pin, 302-4092. Again, kahoot.it. That's all you need to sign in. We have room for 50. We only had just over 20 last time. So let's populate that room, get her nice and full. Just enter your username, and off we go.
Yeah, totally. When's the first time you played Kahoot?
That was at one of our work things.
Right.
That was at a webinar for One Hope Canada. Yes. We're One Hope Canada camp.
Yep.
And they, if you come early to their webinars, they play Kahoot, and you get to test your knowledge. I've won them before.
Yeah, you did. I remember you did win one.
And then I've also lost them.
I've lost, I think, all of the ones I've been a part of.
My favorite was naming myself after our national director.
Oh, yeah. Bill and then McCaskill. I think they had another one after that, and there's probably about at least 10 of us.
Look at all those names. I recognize so many of them.
That's a lot of people.
The Sparrows, the Sunderlands. Kobe, nice. Kobe's eating his donuts.
Amy Ranger. B, hey. Yep. Welcome here.
The Epp family.
Rex is real. I like that.
Crow's back. Nathaniel. The only Nathaniel I know is the Berlandos. Hopefully it's them. The big three.
Big J. Okay, okay.
Chester, yes, all the way from Unity. Chicago's, hey.
Hey, welcome
here,
guys.
They're right beside camp. Yeah, they're... Their relatives started our camp out, actually. Sarah Lynn, one of our program directors.
Yeah.
Let's do one more. Yeah, like 30 seconds more.
Yeah, yeah. We'll give them a couple.
Yeah, we got 39.
Can we push 40? I think we can.
I think we can get more than 40. Ring those phone. Oh, wrong stream. Wrong
yeah,
stream.
Yeah, yeah. We're not Sorry. Doing a telethon.
Yeah, we're not doing a telethon. I think we're stuck at 39, Doug.
Okay.
There it is.
We hit it. We're good. Oh,
hey, the Duicks. Nice. From Rosetown. All right, here we go. Thank you, Austin, for putting me out of my misery.
All right.
Name that Ranger activity.
First question. Here we go. 3, 2, 1.
Boom.
And how deep is the deepest part of the pool at Ranger Lake?
Ooh, 4 feet, 8 feet, 9 feet, or 12 feet?
I honestly don't know this one. I know. I walk by the pool every day when I'm out of camp, but I cannot... recall. I'm honestly guessing, and I
have a picture of it. I could have put that picture of the sign up, but I didn't do that.
I want to say 12 feet.
You're going to say 12?
Yeah.
I already know the answer because I made this one, so you're wrong.
Am I wrong?
It's not 12, no.
What? Oh.
It's 9 feet.
9 feet.
Are you playing, Austin? No? Oh, that's what he guessed. Okay. Yep, good job. And that puts Nathaniel. Nathaniel knows that because his son, when he was very young, tried climbing the fence into the pool. And was not impressed about that one. So he knows how deep it is.
That's fair.
Good job, Nathaniel.
Oh, yeah. Most of our canoes are this color. Ooh. Red, blue, silver, or green?
Good question. Good question.
And once again, if you wait, this is one of those ones where you should be able to
painfully obvious. We have 3 aluminum canoes.
Yep.
We have, including your canoe, we have 3 green canoes.
Yes.
And we have 7 red canoes, but we also have 3 more for our Wild Camp North camp coming, and they're all red. So
we're very excited about that.
Yes, good job, good job,
great job.
That puts dun dun dun
Nathaniel still at top.
E Norma, thank you, Cody, for that one.
I love it.
Oh, Cody.
All right. What is the name of this activity?
Sumo soccer, bubble boy. Is it, oh man, I can't even, roly poly or bubble soccer?
Man, I'm thinking about changing the name of this activity.
To Bubble Boy?
That's pretty good.
I mean, yeah. No,
Bubble Boy, for sure.
It might be Bubble
for
Boy.
For sure. Or, yeah, maybe even like Roly Poly. I mean, that's pretty sweet name.
Roly Poly is pretty sweet.
I feel like that's a good name for an activity in these devices.
It could be. Yeah. Yes. Yes, in these devices. Yep. It's Bubble Soccer.
Good job. You guys got it.
Proud of you.
Oh, but
the
Nathaniel.
White girls.
Woohoo! Okay. All right, so all we got a little switch out.
Booting the other people out. The person who spots a wall climber is called a?
Ooh, is it belayer, spotter, umpire, or dispensationalist? I mean, that is hard.
They might be a dispensationalist. Probably not if they're working at our camp, though.
Who knows?
Those of you who know me and have been around for my terrible jokes and comments know that that's one of my favorite words is dispensationalism. Yes, it's a belayer.
Hey,
good job.
It just makes you sound smart when
it,
you
it
don't
does,
even have to know
what the word
is. But
you're not actually smart to use that word.
No.
Yeah.
Okay, third place, David Way, us, and Wyatt girls. Mm. Okay.
Question five. The style of horseback riding taught at Ranger is known as?
Ooh, is it English, Western,
Dressage
or rodeo?
Yeah!
That is interesting.
Do you know which one?
I actually do. I actually do know this one.
Okay.
And I'll give you guys 4 seconds to figure out what that is, but it's Western.
Yes, it is.
We do not do the proper English riding.
Yes, there's a horn. Dressage is also a kind of English riding. I had a friend in school who did dressage.
Really?
Okay. Oh, we are in first. Us is in first. Good job, us. Nice. And the Wyatt girls and Kiwi. Next question. This water version of Duck Duck Goose is named?
Ooh, is it water everywhere? Douse duck? Mm-hmm. Squirt camp or drip, drip, drop? That's a great question.
Squirt camp.
I know, you had to throw it in.
Yeah, you did have
had to.
Throw it in.
I mean, it fits the game very well.
Mm-hmm.
And if you've ever gone through our registration system, you know it's not that.
Drip, drip, drop. Good drip, job, drip, everyone. Drop. Water everywhere. That'd be a good one, too.
That is another good name.
Oh, man. Nathaniel's back on the climb.
Okay.
Everybody else holding steady. Nice. All right, next question. The proper term for the feathers at the back end of an arrow is?
Is it fletching? Feathers, fins, or I can't even read.
Frappuccinos.
Oh, Frappuccinos. That's what I'm reading here. Okay.
Orange Frappuccinos.
Very nice. Very nice. Very nice.
What do you guys think? Oh, the answers are pouring in as people are searching Google for the answer.
It's true. You could Google it, but.
You probably could. It's
hey,
fletching. You
good
got
job.
It right. Fins. Oh.
Fins. That I can understand
the
confusion.
Wow, the Wyatt girls got that wrong.
Okay.
Dun, dun, dun.
It's amazing how you just disappear.
What
if
a
you get
fall
one wrong.
From grace, hey?
It's just how close this race is. All
name
right,
this
so.
Favorite bowling game played at Fall Frolic. Is it lawn bowling? Is it ranger ball? Is it bocce ball? Or is it oldie bowling?
Ooh. It's a very popular sport when we have our seniors camp.
It is. I missed Fall Frolic. Oh,
I do
man.
Too.
I don't want to. No spoilers here, but I really feel like we're going to have Fall Frolic this fall.
I think that would be awesome.
I'm pretty confident. Yeah, 23, hey. Bocce ball. You got it, everyone.
We good miss you job. Guys.
This next question is for you. I keep stealing them from you.
Oh, Doug. It's all good. The journalist is on the board.
What?
Nice. Welcome back. Here we go. All right. Name this chapel game where campers search for Bible verses. Okay. So sword drill, Bible boogie, verse rehearse or hallelujah, I found it.
Hallelujah.
I feel like after this game, we're just changing everything that we do to different names.
We used to do this more when I was first at camp, you know, like 20-something years ago.
Oh.
It's a sword drill.
Hey.
Yeah.
I remember this when I went to Echo Lake Bible Camp. I believe we
really?
Had sword drills
that
as
was
well.
Also another One Hope Camp.
Yep.
Steve Duncan, shout out. Us is back in the lead or still in the lead.
Okay. Juju and, has appeared.
Yep, Juju has appeared. Next, last question.
All right, I got you. We've got, name this activity. Okay.
What is this?
What is it? Is it dodgeball, hide and go seek, paintball, wall climbing? Well, I don't see any ropes, so I'm pretty sure wall climbing is probably out of the picture at this point.
Oh, that's pouring in now.
Oh, there we go.
I don't think it's dodgeball, Doug.
I don't think so.
It's paintball.
It's kind of like dodgeball. I mean, you do dodge like small.
I guess hiding
ones.
And go seeking can be a part of that.
That's true. It is a part
depending
of
depending on the game. Divid Way, good job. Right. Divid in three.
Kiwi.
Second place. First place.
Drum roll, please.
Bum, bum, bum.
Who do we got?
Us.
Whoever
so
us is.
So everybody just give yourself a pat on the back.
Look at your neighbor and say, you're awesome. You're just doing so fantastic. If
we
anyone's
are
going to
sing some camp songs, so let me grab my guitar. To satisfy the voting on our Instagram, the first song won't have lyrics because it came right down to the wire, and it's the Moose song. So I will sing, and my helpers are going to echo, and you can echo along. There was a moose who liked to drink a lot of juice.
Who liked to drink a lot of juice.
There was a moose.
There was a moose.
Who liked to drink a lot of juice.
Who liked to drink a lot of juice.
Singing way oh way
oh. Singing way oh way oh.
Way oh way oh way oh. His name was Fred.
The moose's name was Fred.
He liked to drink his juice and bread.
He liked to drink his juice and bread.
The moose's name was Fred.
The moose's name was Fred.
He liked to drink his juice and bread.
He liked to drink his juice and bread.
Singing way oh way oh.
Singing way oh way oh.
Way oh way oh way oh way oh.
Way oh way oh way oh way oh.
Way oh way. Drank his juice with care.
He drank his juice with care.
But then he spilt it everywhere.
But then he spilt it everywhere.
He drank his juice with care.
He drank his juice with care.
But then he spilt it everywhere.
But then he spilt it everywhere.
Singing way oh way oh.
Singing way oh way oh.
Way oh way oh way oh way oh.
Way oh way oh way oh way oh.
Way oh way oh.
Way oh way oh.
Way oh way oh way oh way oh. He's a sticky moose.
Now he's a sticky moose.
Because he spilt all of his juice.
Because he spilt all of his juice.
Now he's a sticky moose.
Now he's a sticky moose.
Because he spilt all of his juice.
Because he spilt all of his juice.
Singing way oh way oh.
Singing way oh way oh.
Way oh way oh way oh way oh. It's the end of the song.
Now it's the end of the song.
Because all the juice is gone.
Because all the juice is gone.
Now it's the end of the song.
Now it's the end of the song.
Because all the juice is gone.
Because all the juice is gone.
Singing way oh way oh.
Singing way oh way oh.
Way oh way oh way oh way oh.
Way oh way oh way oh way oh.
Way.
Everybody.
All right, let's get this campfire going.
This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. And then he gave me the gift of love. Tuesday, peace came from above. Told me to have more faith. Thursday gave me a little more grace. Friday told me to watch and pray. Saturday told me just what to say. Sunday gave me the power to find just to let my little light shine.
Woo!
This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine. From above shines on me and it shines on you and it shows the power of love in me. Shine my light both far and near, shine my light both bright and clear. Forever dark corner in this year land, gonna let my little light shine.
Woo!
This little light of mine, I'm
How about another favorite?
I will declare my joy to the nations. I will sing joy in the congregation. I will worship God, worship God. All my days and those who love the Lord are satisfied. Those who trust in Him are justified. I will serve my God, serve my God.
Singing. We are going to have some camp updates right now. We have a camp program update in a bit, but we're going to start off with a campsite update, what's been going on at our camp and what we'd like to happen next. So We're going to play the video. We're going to take you to Ranger Lake Bible Camp as it was, oh, probably 5 days ago. See you there.
Welcome to Ranger Lake Bible Camp on this beautifully chilly April spring day. I want to talk to you about what's going on at our campsite, so come along with me. First of all is our lagoon project. Our lagoon project was started this summer. A lot of work happened this fall. The lagoon is finished. The force main is finished. The lift station is almost finished. This spring, the contractor will complete the installation of all the necessary innards so we can complete the transfer and start making deposits in our new lagoon. You can also see here our new playing field. It's not quite ready for grass, but we'll be working hard this season to prepare this area for grass seed, for irrigation. Our hope is that summer 2022, new playing field for camp games at Ranger Lake. We can't wait. What's next after that for capital projects, you ask? It's our pool bathroom. Welcome to the luxurious pool bathrooms here at Ranger Lake. We've been aware of issues with these bathrooms for quite a while. We have a lot of campers and not so much laundry facility. There's just not enough fixtures in these bathrooms to accommodate all the campers we have on the campsite. Moreover, the design of the building, the layout of the building, even the sloping of the floor make this building very difficult to keep clean. We want to change that. We want to change that by adding floor space, by adding a bigger laundry facility, and by redoing the whole thing. So we will end up removing this building and replacing it with something larger and better suited for this role. Those plans are being produced right now by our site committee, and you can look for that information this fall at our fall banquet. For now, how about you come back outside with me? You know, summer camp just isn't the same without campers. Man, Ranger Ball just isn't the same without campers either. Our plan is to have campers on our campsite this summer. We've been in contact with people from the government, but working really hard at advocating for summer camps province-wide has been our executive director of the Saskatchewan Camps Association, Holly Epp. Here's a quick message from her about summer camps this summer.
Hi friends, my name is Holly. I'm the executive director over at the Saskatchewan Camps Association, and part of my job over the last 12 months has been advocating for camps because we know that camp matters. We know that we need camp in our lives, and we missed it because it got shut down because of COVID-19 and the restrictions that needed to come into place. And so over the last 12 months, I've been talking with the government. I've been able to talk to MLAs, to cabinet ministers, and particularly to the business response team, who's been helping me come up with a great proposal for running safe overnight camps. If camps were to run tomorrow, it would be restricted to day camps, but we're really hopeful as we've gotten some positive feedback from our decision makers, and even in writing some letters saying that they're very optimistic for the summer and for operations of camp. And they've just encouraged me to keep doing what I've been doing and talking to the business response and making sure that when we run, we can have confidence that it's a great place for all campers and all staff to be this summer. We know that camp matters because we love the place of community that it creates, this place of belonging. We get to learn amazing new skills, hang out with our friends, make new friends, and have those caring adults and mentors and staff in our lives. And so I really hope that we can see camp happen. I hope that you guys are all out there. I hope that you're enjoying the sunshine, being off of your screens, getting unplugged from your devices that we've been so dependent on over the last year, and that we really get to just come back and gather together again because camp matters. So thanks for being a part of this fundraising event and supporting Ranger Lake. See you guys.
Awesome. Well, that is great to hear from Holly. We're so thankful for everything that the SCA does for us and all the work that Holly has done advocating for camps to have overnights this summer. And we are truly thankful for everything she does. As for summer, what is going on? Well, right now we have about 80 registrations for our camps right now, which are currently on our website, our three-day day camps. Now, our hope is that, like Holly was mentioning, that the government will give us a call and we'll be able to run our overnight programming. If that happens, our game plan is to switch the flip and be able to move all of our day camps to full week overnight camps, Sunday to Friday. Now, what can you do to prep for camp this summer? Well, one thing I would highly recommend is that you register for summer camps. Register for them right now because of the fact that when you register, then you will have a spot saved for summer and you will be the first to be notified as to the overnight. So please make sure that you register today. We'd love to see those come in and have your spot reserved, especially when we switch to overnights. The other thing that I want to highlight is our summer missions team. We missed out last summer on building a large team where we could build into young lives and disciple in the way that we normally do. And so we want to do that this summer. We are committing to hiring for that overnight plan. And so we are looking for a few key positions. In particular, we're looking for a head cook, volunteer cooks to come out from week to week, as well as male senior and junior cabin leaders. We're also looking for junior female cabin leaders, as well as a head wrangler. So if any of those positions interest you or you want to get involved and be a part of the Ranger team, please go to our website and be sure to fill out an application. We'd love for you to participate in what God has planned this summer at Ranger Lake. You know, we're excited to be running missions on site this summer, and we can't wait for you guys to join us. And so I'm going to invite Greg back on the stage for some more updates.
Thanks, Doug. We are a Bible camp, and so maybe I should read some Bible for us right now. John 10, verse 11 and following. I am the good shepherd. This is Jesus speaking. I'm the good shepherd. The good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep. The hired hand, since he's not the shepherd, doesn't own the sheep, leaves them and runs away when he sees a wolf coming. The wolf then snatches and scatters them. This happens because he's a hired hand and he doesn't care about the sheep. I am the good shepherd. I know my own and my own know me, just as the Father knows me and I know the Father. I lay my life down for the sheep. I hope that you've heard loud and clear that the gospel is important to us tonight. I hope that you've heard that discipleship, discipling those young lives that have made decisions for Jesus, that that's been important to us as well. And we know that Jesus has not left us. Yes, this has been a hard year. Yes, we've been stretched emotionally, spiritually. We've been stretched financially. But we know that Jesus has not left us because he is good, and he is the good shepherd. I want to encourage you with that. Wherever you're at today, that Jesus has not left you, even though things are hard, Jesus is not a stranger to suffering, and he can accompany you through difficult times as he has me, as he has the rest of our Ranger team, and as he has for Christians for years gone by. A couple other things I want to point out. First of all is a work day on May 1st. We're hoping that's a Saturday. I think it's a Saturday. Yes, it's a Saturday. We're hoping to get some work done at camp. We've got some fun and needed improvements to continue to do at our camp. So bob@rlbc.ca is your ticket if you want to help out at camp. We always need help chainsawing trees and splitting wood and cleaning cabins and preparing our dining hall and things like that. We're always looking for electricians and plumbers, people with skid steers, things like that. We're just going to make a giant mess of our campsite. No, we won't. It'll be great. But come out and join us. I'd love to see you and shake your hand from a distance or whatever we do nowadays with this crazy world we're in. We'll provide you with food that day as well. So May 1st, get in contact with Bob if you want to come to camp. Thanks, Austin. You can take that off the screen. What else? Oh, man. I want to be clear here that we are running day camps as of right now, but we are really hoping and praying that that we can run overnights. And like Holly said, we've had some strong indications from our legislators. They're aware that that is what we want. The line that we've said to them again and again has been, the kids have paid so much for what's gone on. Let's give them their summer. So could you join us in praying for that? Could you join us in praying that God will give kids, not just at Ranger Lake, but across our province and across our nation, summer camp overnight this summer? We'd appreciate that. Thanks so much for joining us tonight. Thanks so much for all those who delivered donuts for us. Thank you so much for all the board members and everybody that makes this kind of thing happen. Thanks to Austin for holding down the fort, letting us use his place here at Cornerstone Church. Thanks so much for the congregants and the staff members at Cornerstone Church for letting us use their place and their streaming equipment. We sure appreciate it. We are going to close with the same song we close camp with every week, and that is Humble Yourself and Awesome God. yourself in the sight of the Lord.
Humble yourself in the sight of the
Lord. In the sight of the Lord.
Humble yourself in the sight of the Lord.
Humble yourself in the sight of the Lord. God, we are so thankful that you are a God of hope and that you don't leave us. And God, we know that we have seen your power, that you've moved so powerfully in the past when things have looked bleak and when things have been difficult. And we look to you, Father. We have nowhere else to look. And our eyes are fixed on you, and our hope is not placed in anywhere else but in your power through the shed blood of your Son, Jesus. And that's where we trust, and that's how we pray. We pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Hey, thank you guys so much for coming to our live stream. And we're so excited for, just what God's going to do this summer.
We are. You know, there's some other things we have planned. I know we didn't get to everything tonight. If you have any questions, you can fill out the contact form on our website and get in touch with us. You can drop us a phone call if you want to have a chat, whatever you'd like. So you know, and so you hear it from us, we want to see you. And we want to get together like we do every Father's Day. I'm probably not going to happen for a free-for-all this spring. We'll let you know if it does. But some way, somehow, we'd like to have that experience at camp this season. So keep your ear to the ground for stuff like that. We'll change as it comes forward. We're really good at adapting.
Oh, yeah.
But we miss you. Thank you so much for joining us.
All right. And keep posted on our social media accounts. We will tell you guys about what our total is at the end, near the end of the month, as our credit card totals come in.
Yep.
Awesome.
God bless. Thanks, everyone.
Bye, everybody.